All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Well, welcome back. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. First time, long time, either way. Try to break it all down here. Portland, Oregon. We are talking about the Ducks. We are talking about Pac-12 basketball. We're going to combine both these in one video. And we're talking about, we're 1 week out from Selection Sunday. It is Sunday right now, March 3rd. Just watched the end of the Beaver game and had some thoughts there. So we'll talk about what happened for the whole Pac-12 this weekend. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Ducks a little bit as well. So let's get right into it. First things first, the Duckies. The Ducks, finally, that's the team we're looking to see. Finally, we get a huge, huge weekend of basketball against the Arizona schools at home. Arizona State, one of the better teams in the conference this year. Arizona, not so much. They've had their ups and downs, but Arizona's still Arizona. Still got great talent on that team. Always have, always will. Be basically the best team in the conference. You know, after UCLA's epic run of the 1970s, Arizona has basically held the torch for this conference for a good 30 years. I understand they're on a little bit of tough times right now, but it is the case. And for Oregon schools to go through the Arizona schools the way that they did this weekend was something else. Absolutely tremendous. So, huge weekend for the Arizona schools. So, I really like what we see with Oregon right now. Oregon is playing great defense. They're locking teams down. I think they let Arizona score 16 points in the second half or something. That's just tremendous. Really, really did a good job against ASU. I think the offense will take care of itself. They have enough scorers on the team, but they just got to lock it down defensively. And that zone, if the other team is working well against you, that zone is hard to defend against. Sometimes for other teams, it's hard to operate against. So there's some teams that can shoot against it. There's some teams that can operate through it. Other teams that can't. And Arizona, both these Arizona schools could not deal with it. Now, Washington, on the other hand, I think can be a completely different ballgame because they run the same type of zone. So Oregon this week plays Washington State and Washington, and I think you might split them. Now, early on, I thought Oregon could get Washington, but the way that Oregon played against Washington in the first game makes me believe Oregon can beat Washington. Washington struggled this weekend. They had a tough, tough game against Cal. I mean, holy smokes. The game against Cal was just ridiculous, right? They just couldn't get out of the way. Cal finally gets the first win of the entire Pac-12 season, and it's against the by far the best team in the league. And then today, they go right down to the wire, and Stanford almost beats them. Washington holds on at the very end on that one. Stanford had a shot at the end, and a pretty scattered shot. Erratic, the case may be. ASU comes right down to the wire against Oregon State and wins late. So Arizona State, Washington, the two best teams in the conference this year, are barely hanging on against these other teams. This is going to be a wild Pac-12 conference. The announcers have said it, but the people who are going, we are super excited for this one because the Pac-12 tournament, in some years, it's a runaway. You know exactly what's going to happen before it happens. And then now this year, I think, is going to be a very, very unique thing. So the Arizona State game for Washington was just abysmal. The fact that they were able to turn that around and beat the Beavs this weekend, I think, is huge. It says a lot about Arizona State's resiliency. Washington losing to Cal, you know, it wasn't like they got blown out. They lost by 3 points. They just never really felt like they could engage. They never really felt like they could get over the hump. And then Colorado and Utah played this weekend. Colorado beat them. And Washington State's playing better basketball. They lose to Cal as well. So Cal gets a sweep. Huge, huge deal there. But again, Oregon shutting down Arizona, not letting Arizona score 50 points is just a tremendous, tremendous way to end this season. So this week, Oregon plays Washington State up there in Pullman. Weird things happen up there. It's going to be a big one for them. I think Oregon beats Washington State. And then coming down the stretch against Washington, I think it's going to be difficult. And you look across the rest of the Pac-12, Arizona State plays Arizona. I think that's going to be a very interesting game. The way Arizona State's playing, I would assume they're going to win that game. The Beavs are going to do the same trip that we're going to do. I think they might be in the same similar situation. They might beat Washington State, but might lose to Washington. If Oregon State loses to Washington in the first game, maybe Oregon can beat them. Maybe Washington splits with the Oregon schools. I don't know. And then UCLA and Utah. Utah's a really interesting team. Colorado's a really interesting team. UCLA is an interesting team. It's just chaotic. I've never really seen a Pac-12 conference go like this, or Pac-10 conference go like this. As of right now, you've got basically 2 through 10 that we really don't know what's going on. We know Cal, we know Washington State, we know Washington, and basically we know ASU. So you could pretty much put them off the map. But everybody else, they've now got to really work for it. Arizona State has obviously still have a big game in front of them. But them beating Oregon State was a big deal for them, because then that secures them for second place. That gets them an automatic qualifier. They're going to have a bye in that first round of the Pac-12 tournament. And you've got just slew of teams in the middle. Washington, is so far ahead of the rest of it that I think that actually might be better for the Pac-12. You might actually get another team in the NCAA tournament because Washington's been so dominant. I would love to see a wild scenario where Washington goes in automatically, ASU goes in on the bubble, maybe as a play-in team, and then a team like Oregon or a team like Colorado, who did that a couple years ago where they went from start to finish and won the Pac-12 tournament, can win the Pac-12 tournament, get the automatic qualifier, we get three teams in. Obviously, I'd love to see Oregon win the Pac-12 tournament. That would be tremendous, but anybody basically 2 through 10 could do it. Stanford could do it. So it's just a wild year this year. It's been super fun to watch. So hopefully everybody has enjoyed it. And then we will continue this next week, and then we'll get right down to it, and I'll get you some stuff, if I can, in Vegas, some of the updates if I can there. When I am there. All right, people, thank you guys so much. Adios.